Let's go to Mars.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky. The planet Mars is back in the nighttime sky and looking big, bright, and beautiful.
And red.
Exactly.
Currently, we have several unmanned spacecraft circling Mars and two rovers rolling on Mars. So it got us thinking, what would it be like to visit Mars?
Up close.
In person.
So, this week we'll show you where to find Mars in the earthly sky and then take you on a journey across millions of miles to the red planet. Let's go.
Okay, we have our sky set up for Thursday, June 16th, facing south. We're close to the summer solstice, so it doesn't get really dark until after 10 p.m. So our view here is at 11 p.m.
Excellent. I love any excuse to stay up late with the stars and planets. And there's a lot to see in the southern sky this week. On Thursday, we'll be having the waxing gibbous moon above Mars. Yep, that bright reddish star is actually the red planet.
Cool. And it's so easy to find right now. Over to the left, you'll spot two fainter objects. The dimmer one is the star Antares, the beating heart of the constellation Scorpius Scorpion, and the brighter one on the left is the ringed planet Saturn.
Ah, my favorite, but I'll stay focused on Mars since that's our destination today.
Good idea. But first, let's see how things change over the week. On Friday night, the moon will shift to the left, and on Saturday night, it will cozy up next to Saturn.
Nice.
Then on Sunday and Monday, the moon will continue on its way, but still leave our two planets and one bright shining star to the south.
Now comes the fun part. Let's blast off for Mars and take you in for a closer look. Up, up, and away!
This week, Mars is almost 50 million miles from Earth.
When Earth and Mars are properly positioned, it takes a rocket about 7 months to make the trip, but we'll get you there in a few seconds.
As we approach the red planet, we'll first notice that it's not super red. It looks more orange, brown, pink, and rusty. And that's because there's a lot of iron in the rocks of Mars that actually have rusted over time.
The bright white areas are the polar ice caps. There's lots of dry ice around the Martian poles, but also a fair amount of water ice. Maybe we can chip off a few pieces and add them to our drinks.
Before we land, let's fly by Mars's two moons. First up is Deimos, the smaller one. It's less than 8 miles across and circles the planet every 30 hours.
Then we come to the larger moon Phobos. It's still very small, only about 14 miles wide. Despite being covered in craters, Phobos might make a great base of operations for future manned missions.
It could be a stopover for astronauts or an orbiting observatory to watch the planet more closely.
Someday, astronauts may shuttle down to Mars and back from this little moon. All right, we made it. We're the first humans to reach the surface of Mars.
And what a view. Most of Mars looks like a dry, desolate orange desert with rocks strewn about and deep craters. Any water on Mars is hidden below the ground or is frozen in the ice caps. But you can also find tall mountains like Olympus Mons, which is 3 times taller than any mountain on the Earth, and deep valleys like Valles Marineris, which is 2,500 miles long and 5 times deeper than the Grand Canyon.
Plus, there's two rovers still rolling on Mars. Hey, look, there's the Curiosity rover climbing Mount Sharp. Hey, Curiosity! We may still be decades away from sending humans to Mars, but one can always dream. So, this week, look for Mars in the southern sky after dark.
And when you find it, dream about taking a journey to the red planet.
You can visit its two moons and kick up some red Martian dust.
It's all there when you keep looking up.